Human life is the miniature reflection of the universe. Yatha pinde, tatha brahmande. The universe and its cosmic energy flows in all living and non-living life forms. And everything draws essence of life from the miraculous force called nature. Millenniums ago, in the Vedic era, intellectual discussions between sages revealed the knowledge of life, which we now know as Ayurveda, the art of healthy living, a unique branch of medicinal science that draws preventive, curative, and remedial measures from the lab of nature. Documented in various Vedic hymns and rooted in the fundamental philosophies of life, disease, and health, as noted in Atharvaveda, this curative tradition is an integral part of the Indian identity. It is widely believed in the country that Lord Dhanvantri emerged with the great knowledge of Ayurveda during Samudra Manthan. Over the time, Ayurveda has established its principles through endless research and understanding. Scientific efforts to explore the discipline as per modern perspective have led to global acceptance and popularity of this ancient science. The Government of India established the Central Council for Research in Indian Medicine and Homeopathy in 1969 under the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare to create a steady foundation for Indian systems of medicine. Further, to boost in-depth scientific research, the Department of Ayush was established in 1995. Seeing the potential of this science, Independent Ministry of Ayush was created in 2014. To uphold and highlight its unique heritage, the Government of India has over the decades taken various necessary measures to regularize and standardize its Indian traditional systems of medicines. Over the time after its inception, Central Council for Research in Indian Medicine and Homeopathy too branched out its separate entities focusing on individual specializations like Ayurveda, Yoga, Naturopathy, Yunani, Siddha and Homeopathy. And this is how in the year 1978, Central Council for Research in Ayurveda and Siddha came into existence. In the year 2011, it was further bifurcated into Central Council for Research in Ayurvedic Sciences and Central Council for Research in Siddha. The Central Council for Research in Ayurvedic Sciences, or CCRAS, is an autonomous body under the Ministry of Ayush, Government of India. And its primary role involves formulating, coordinating, developing and promoting scientific research in the field of Ayurveda and Sowa Rigpa.
The Central Council for Research in Ayurvedic Sciences is a significant arm of the Ministry of Ayush for research on scientific lines in the discipline of Ayurveda. This council has been contributing substantially to the objective of our government, which is to preserve and promote the well-being of the citizens of our country.
The council have been using modern techniques and scientific parameters for creating evidence-based, safe, quality and effective Ayurvedic drugs and formulations.
The Central Council for Research in Ayurvedic Sciences has been working diligently and consistently since its formation. It is a matter of great satisfaction that in the recent years, through high quality scientific works, the Council has been successful in making strides in the field of medical research.
Our vision at Council is to strive for excellence in the field of Ayurveda by comprehensive research for quality assured and cost effective products to prevent, manage, cure various diseases.
engaged in the validation of classical medicines and drug development of new and coded formulations through a series of intramural and collaborative projects. The Council is conducting clinical research through its 26 research institutes with OPD and IPD facilities. CCRAS has a well-defined research policy for executing intramural and collaborative research. The research policy of the Council is aimed at encouraging its scientists for the formulation, submission, and execution of research projects to meet the objectives of quality research through its wide network of 30 peripheral institutes, including national institutes, regional centers, and various units located all over India.
The headquarter office is responsible for control, monitoring, and supervision. 17 Ayurvedic formulations for reproductive and child health care program has also been developed by this council.
Ayurveda advocates a personalized therapeutic approach as it recognizes every individual to hold a specific constitution called Prakriti. The Council is working to validate fundamental and core Ayurvedic concepts such as these. A standardized Prakriti assessment scale has been developed by CCRAS, and it is also working towards validation of Ayurvedic diagnostic tool to develop standardized Ayurveda case-taking protocol.
CCRAS has developed standardized Prakriti assessment scale and Ayu Prakriti web portal as a tool for standardized assessment of Prakriti.
According to Ayurveda, a natural state is one of health, happiness, and an inner sense of well-being. Panchakarma is an ancient Ayurvedic practice which aids an individual to attain such a natural state through five actions or five purificatory therapies of nature, namely Vaman, Virechan, Niruh Basti, Anuvasana Basti, and Nasya. The procedures are advocated in various therapeutic indications as prescribed by physicians suited to individual Prakriti. CCRAS has proactively promoted Panchakarma treatment facilities, making it easily available at various institutes like National Ayurveda Research Institute of Panchakarma, Cheruthuruthi in Kerala, which is dedicated for research and validation of Panchakarma procedures, especially in neuromuscular and musculoskeletal disorders through its IPD and OPD facility. Similarly, Kshar Sutra is another unique Ayurvedic parasurgical procedure and time-tested Ayurvedic technique in the management of anorectal disorders like piles and fistula. Since inception, preparation of Kshar Sutra involved multiple stages of skillful manual techniques, strictly adhering to the 10th century chronicles. Moreover, due to manual preparation and limited production, the access of this treatment is restricted to limited population. The Council has recently developed a unique, cost-effective and safe technique for automation of standardized Kshar Sutra preparation in collaboration with IIT Delhi. The automated machine has separate chambers for the four stages of preparation, which are thread winding, coating, dusting, and drying chamber.
This is enabling speedy production of the standard Kshar Sutra, confirming the parameters of modern medical standards. Further, to prove its efficacy on clinical parameters, this council has also used it clinically and found it equally effective in terms of its tolerability and all other clinical parameters. Moreover, it complies with the standardized parameters of Ayurvedic Pharmacopoeia of India.
But that's not all. The Council is further executing various research activities through its wide network of 30 peripheral institutes, including national institutes, regional centers, and various units located all over India. Its research activities include clinical research, fundamental research, medicinal plant research, drug standardization, pharmacological research, and literary research and documentation. Besides, CCRAS is also extending healthcare services through outreach activities such as Tribal Healthcare Research Program, Ayurveda Mobile Healthcare Program under Schedule Caste Subplan, Ayurveda Mobile Healthcare Program, Swasthya Rakshan Program, Integration of Ayurveda with National Program for Prevention and Control of Cancer, Diabetes, Cardiovascular Diseases and Strokes, and Ayurvedic Health Centers under Northeast Plan, etc. The Tribal Healthcare Research Program under Tribal Subplan was initiated with the aim to study the living conditions of tribal people, understand folk medicines and local health traditions used by them, gauge the availability of medicinal plants in the area and for propagation of knowledge about hygiene and prevention of diseases by encouraging the use of common medicinal plants in the area and to extend medical aid at their doorsteps. The program is executed at 15 peripheral institutes and units. The council has extended healthcare services in 1,899 villages and tribal pockets covering a population of more than 11,88,353, where medical aid and counselling was offered to 4,20,693 people. Through these outreach activities, and it has so far documented 1,137 folk claims and local health traditions. Swasthya Rakshan Program was initiated in November 2015 in 21 institutes across 19 Indian states with the aim to make people aware of the importance of good health, cleanliness of domestic surroundings and environment for propagation of knowledge about hygiene and to provide medical aid to the patients of selected colonies and villages. A total 411 villages and colonies were covered through 9,408 tours across 19 states, providing medical aid to 2,79,362 patients. The Ayurveda Mobile Healthcare Program under Schedule Caste's subplan was initiated during November 2015 in 20 institutes across 18 Indian states. It started out with the aim to study the living conditions of these communities, propagation hygiene awareness, prevention of diseases, and to provide medical aid at their doorsteps. A total 519 villages and colonies covered through 8,494 tours reached a population of 4,12,863 and provided medical aid to 2,11,354 patients. In addition to healthcare services, the council also generates data for research through these outreach activities with an aim to gauge the overall situation of patients, ailments, and indigenous medical systems. With an agenda to infuse the benefits of natural and traditional medicines for both curative and preventive results, CCRAS is working proactively to integrate Ayurveda with NPCDCS, a national program for prevention and control of cancer, diabetes, cardiovascular diseases, and stroke. The program has been implemented and is running successfully in identified districts across three states.
The council is also actively involved in the national program for prevention and control of cancer, diabetes, cardiovascular diseases and stroke. The results of the program are promising in the management of these diseases and it has unraveled the potential of integration of Ayurveda and yoga with conventional system of medicine.
Given India's vast natural reserves and biodiversity, the country is home to a huge variety of medicinal plants, which has further helped propagate and encourage holistic medicinal practices like Ayurveda. Naturally, the conservation of medicinal plant value is an essential component under the Medicinal Plant Research Program of the Council. Pharmacognosy an applied science which involves the study of physical, chemical, biochemical and biological properties of natural drug substances, and the search for new drugs from natural sources is an important and indispensable part of pharmaceutical education. Understanding its potential, CCRAS established Pharma Cognostical Research Units at Bengaluru and Kolkata. Moreover, the Medico-Ethno-Botanical Survey Program of CCRAS plays a pivotal role in the documentation of medicinal plants of India. The Council has surveyed every phytogeographic region from the Himalayan Alpine ranges to coastal areas of Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Through its five peripheral institutes at Bengaluru, Guwahati, Itanagar, Jhansi and Ranikhet. These institutes have been instrumental in collecting and preserving more than 120,000 herbarium specimens and about 5,000 museum specimens from several survey units spread across the country. So far, the Council has carried out pharmacognostical studies on 400 single drugs, phytochemical studies of 220 drugs, physicochemical constants of 889 single drugs and 623 formulations, and the statics improve steadily. Since time immemorial, medicinal plants have been used in the mitigation and treatment of various ailments. Therefore, identification of crude drug is a fundamental step in the formulation of plant-based drugs. Cultivation of medicinal plant under medicinal plant research program is another crucial segment. The preeminent objectives of cultivation of medicinal plant includes adaptability, growth, flowering and fruiting time of medicinal plants, including suitable maturity time. Considering this, the Council established five demonstrative cultivation gardens at Pune, Jhansi, Itanagar, Tarikhet and Leh. A major thrust area of the Council is to develop quality standards of single and compound formulations and standard operating procedures through its peripheral institutes in Chennai, Kolkata, Patiala, Gwalior and Cherutthurathi. Units of the Council are working to generate data on standardization, development of standard operating procedures and physiochemical analysis of Ayurvedic drugs. In addition to these, testing of formulations for quality control of the drugs used for clinical trial or OPD are also performed regularly. The aim of standardization is to scientifically validate the quality and safety of single drugs of herbal, mineral, metal and animal origin and to compound formulations as per API guidelines. For this purpose, some of the important parameters incorporated in the format are TLC or HPTLC fingerprinting profile, determination of microbial load, heavy and toxic metals, pesticide residue, aflatoxins, etc., besides physicochemical parameters. Drug formulation and validation are incomplete without toxicity study. Hence, it is one of the major research areas of CCRAS. Pharmacological and toxicological studies constitute a very vital part in drug research program. Under pharmacology research, Ayurvedic drugs are studied for their toxicity evaluation and biological activity in various areas such as bronchial asthma, diabetes mellitus, immunomodulation, wound healing, etc. So far, pharmacological studies of about 500 Ayurvedic drug formulations and toxicity study of more than 200 Ayurvedic drug formulations have been conducted. These studies are conducted in CCRAS institutes at Kolkata, Chennai, Gwalior, Cherutthurathi and Pune. CCRAS helps scientists in their efforts to identify, protect and stop commercial exploitation of new knowledge generated through their research work. Under the IPR policy, CCRAS develops unique Ayurvedic formulations in order to safeguard its ownership, protection and against exploitation of intellectual property. Till date, 17 patents have been awarded to CCRAS for unique formulations like Ayush 64 for malaria, Ayush Ghutti for cold and cough, Ayush 56 for epilepsy, etc. Further, these technologies are transferred from research centers to industry. And at present, 12 technologies have been transferred to industry for commercialization, namely Ayush 82, Ayush SG, Ayush 64, etc. The council is dedicated to revive and retrieve texts from ancient manuscripts and rare books, which includes collection and compilation of references relating to drugs and diseases from classical treaties, lexicographic work, contemporary literature and publications related to Ayurveda and other medical systems. So far, about 235 books, monographs, technical reports, etc. have been published, around 2,500 folk claims collected and 14 books published as a result of the Medico-Ethno-Botanical Survey. The council is also publishing IEC material like brochures, booklets, etc. for wider dissemination of Ayurveda among masses. CCRAS has also prepared e-book of classical Ayurveda textbooks such as Shushrut Samhita, etc. with advanced text search options. The council is committed to the revival and mainstreaming of the ancient therapeutic practice of Marma Chikitsa.
Marma are the vital points of the body, which are the surface anatomical structures which are very elaborately described in Ayurvedic literature, especially in the ancient surgical treatise of Ayurveda, the Shushrut Samhita. These vital points are used for treating many muscular, musculoskeletal and neurological disorders. By unknown causes, the practice of Marma Chikitsa became obsoleted in North India and Northwestern part of the country, but remained very progressive in the South India. This council is committed to the revival and mainstreaming of the ancient therapeutic practice of Marma Chikitsa, the method of curing diseases by stimulating various vital points of the body, and has taken up research project on documentation of effective Marma practices and translation of the books related to Marma Chikitsa.
CCRAS is further publishing periodicals such as the Journal of Research in Ayurvedic Sciences, available at www.grasccras.com, and Journal of Drug Research in Ayurvedic Sciences, available at www.jdrasccras.com. For dissemination of research findings, CCRAS also contributed to traditional knowledge digital library through collection of published materials on Ayurveda, compilation of formulations and generation of traditional knowledge resource classification. The Ministry of Ayush, Government of India, intends to disseminate the merits of Ayush systems across the globe. To implement this thought, a web-based Ayush research portal has been initiated to showcase the related information of these systems, such as evidence-based research data. The CCRAS headquarters and the National Institute of Indian Medical Heritage, Hyderabad, are coordinating and maintaining the web portal in collaboration with National Informatics Center, Hyderabad. About 25,103 research abstracts have been uploaded in the Ayush Research Portal by the contributing Ayush Research Councils, National Institutes, Universities, etc. Around 416,931 visits to this Ayush Research Portal, 255,514 article views, 51,350 article downloads, and visits from 157 countries across the globe have been recorded so far. In order to enhance the global footing of Ayurveda, Siddha and Unani systems of medicine, the Ministry of Ayush has been actively pursuing efforts to include Ayush systems of medicine in the traditional medicine chapter of the International Classification of Diseases. In this regard, CCRAS has been involved in the development of standardized terminologies and morbidity codes for various disease conditions mentioned in Ayurveda for uniform usage of terminologies and also to create a system of centralized morbidity data collection. The National Ayush Morbidity and Standardized Terminologies e-portal is a website exclusively dedicated to the centralized collection of morbidity statistics of various healthcare providing institutions under all Ayush systems spread across the country.
With support from the Ministry of Ayush, the Council has taken a lead in the development of standardized terminology and morbidity code and National Ayush Morbidity Standardized Terminology electronic portal known as Namaste Portal to include Ayush systems of medicine in the traditional medicine chapter of the International Classification of Diseases of World Health Organization.
Understanding the growing need for the safe, natural and effective healthcare system, CCRAS recently proposed a strategy emphasizing the need for research and development of new drugs within a 15-year plan for focused research outcomes. The Council is taking Ayurveda to the world with endless efforts to promote sustainable development of this unique medicinal science using latest techniques with scientific evidence-based studies.
I must acknowledge that the CCRAS has significantly contributed to the scientific advancement in the field of Ayurveda and has been shouldering the task to generate tangible evidence of the classic Ayurveda formulation therapies for their clinical safety and efficacy. We are proud that the Council has successfully maintained the standard for producing the quality research work and contributed to the burgeoning growth of the discipline of Ayurvedic science.
These incessant efforts of CCRAS have contributed to the promotion and growth of Ayurveda through its highly motivated team of scientists, professionals and staff spread across the country. For the commitment, dedication and sincerity for scientific advancements in Ayurveda. This is the beginning of resurrecting a medical legend, an era of the ancient knowledge in full swing.